I hope you are having a great weekend. Soon we'll be back together doing math. Well, let's take a look at this bridge problem. Notice they tell us the origin is here. Remember that the origin represents 0, 0. So what you're going to want to do first here is you're going to want to get some coordinates. You're going to want to get these coordinates. So put some dots here on your bridge. And we're going to find these coordinates first thing. So for example, let's say I want to find this coordinate here. Well, that means I need to know this distance. Well, this line up here represents the total distance from this end of the bridge to this end of the bridge. This distance here represents the middle distance from this point to this point. Okay, so that means that we're going to take 280, subtract 200. What does that leave us with? That leaves us with 80 meters. Now, there's two sections left over. So we're going to take 80 meters divided by 2, and that's going to give us 40 on each side. Okay? So now we know that this point here is going to be 40 on the X, 0 on the Y. 35 millimeters, that's going to represent this height. And obviously it's going to represent this height over here. 20 meters is going to represent below the road, the pillar below the road. So obviously, we're going to have 20 meters on this side. So I helped give you some information so that you can label all of these points. Yes, this point too, the one in the middle. And that's going to help you here. It says, find the coordinates of each of the following points. Add them to the sketch on the front. The point where the road and the left support tower meet. So here's the road, and here's the left support tower. So that point is 40, 0. The point where the road and the right support tower meet. Here's the road. Here's the right support tower. So we're going to have to add our 40 plus our 200. That gives us this point, 240, 0. Okay, I'm going to let you finish doing these coordinates. Okay, number 6, name all the labeled points that are on the roadway. So we want to name them all. So this is going, we're going to name all of these points. So we'll name this point here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and maybe even H over here. You can name them however you want. But when you name a point, we name points using capital letters, if you remember from geometry. So label all of your points using letters. Maybe you even want to start here. And so on. It says write an equation for the roadway. I'm going to let you figure that one out. What is a reasonable domain and range for the roadway? Well, let me ask you a question. Is this roadway discrete or continuous? Hopefully you said continuous. So the domain, starting on the left, starts out at 0. And on the right, let's go ahead and get this coordinate here. How long is the road? 280. and 0 units up, because this is the origin, 0, 0. So our domain is going to go from 0 to 280. Remember, it's continuous, so we have to use these symbols. So 0 on the left, 280 on the right, and they are closed dots. Unless a sinkhole opened up and swallowed the dot on the left, then in that case, you know, then we wouldn't have an equal sign. Ha ha. Okay, range for the roadway. Well, what's the range here? What's the range value? 0. What's the range value here? 0. Range value here? 0. So what's the range? Range is basically 0. You can write it like that, or you could write it like that. Number 7, name all the labeled points that are on the left support tower. So remember here, we labeled points. It says label, now name all the labeled points. So let's say we labeled that A, B, C. You might be different than me, and that's okay. So left support tower would be B, C, and D. I changed it. B, C, and D. Write an equation for the left support tower. The left support tower. Well, it's a vertical line. And remember, vertical lines start off with? That's right. Good job. X. And what does X equal? X equals 40. 40, whatever. 40, 0. 40, whatever we came up with. So X equals 40. And you're going to do your domain and your range for your support tower. Let's take a look at a diagonal now. It says, name all the labeled points that are on the left diagonal support cable. Left diagonal support cable. A, B. Write an equation for the left diagonal support tower. Well, left diagonal support tower, what's the y-intercept? Well, since this is the origin, that means that the y-axis would be right here. And this would be our x-axis. So what's the y-intercept? 0. Okay. So we would start off with plus 0, which most of you know we don't have to write plus 0. Now we want to come up with our slope. So to get from this point, I would rise, how tall? 35. Rise 35. And then how far would I have to run? And we if you remember, that was 40. So our slope is 35 over 40. 35 over 40. Let's reduce that fraction. 5 goes into 35 7 times. Sorry about that. 5 goes into 40 8 times. So 7 eighths equals y. And we're going to do the domain and range again. Okay. Name all, let's go down to 11. Name all the labeled points that are on the parabolic suspension arch. All right. We got B. Let's see, we got A, B, C, D. Let's go ahead and label that E. We could label these points as well, but I'm not going to. F, and so on. So B, E, and F. B, E, and F. Use these points and your graphing calculator to write an equation for the parabola in standard form. So, using your graphing calculator. Well, let me go get mine. Hold on. Okay, on our graphing calculator, we're going to go to Stat, edit, and we're going to put in our points. So let's go back to our quadratic. And let's start with point. Now they give us 2 points right here. Let's go ahead and get E. Let's see, this is going to be halfway. So half of 280 is 140. And the Y on point E would be 0. All right, so let's plug some points in here. So they give us 70, 17. $140, 0, and $210, $17. Good. Now to get the equation, in case you've forgotten how to do that, we're going to go ahead and go to Stat. We're going to go to Calculate. And we're going to do a quadratic regression, number 5. Quadratic regression, enter. Enter, 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 enter. All right. So notice our A value is very, very small. So that tells us we have a vertical compression, remember? All right, let's write this equation. Let's see, move it over here. So we're going to have Y equals 0.003, and let's just go there. We'll round that 4 up to a 5 right here. Okay, x squared, okay, minus 0.9714x plus 68. Okay, if you'll recall, our A value is our vertical stretch or compression. In this case, it's a compression. It's less than 1. And remember, this value over here is our y-intercept. Now, use what you know about parameter changes to write an equation for the parabola in vertex form. All that means is I want, using your parameter changes, okay, your parabola got moved to the right. How many units? Remember, so we're going to write x, it moved to the right, so x minus something. Did it get moved up or down? So remember, you get your h value, your k value, and your a value. Hint, hint, equals y. So right, this is called vertex form. Okay, because it gives you your vertex. We talked about that. Remember, h and k is your vertex value. And then you're going to write your domain and range. Now, when you come to school on Monday, if you haven't completed this worksheet, you're going to work with a partner. And you're going to make sure you agree on everything on this page. Now, your labels might be a little bit different, but your equations, your domain and range, make sure you agree. Hope you're having a great weekend. I'll see you guys on Monday.